Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum and good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. The highlights of last week include the incoming visits of Turkish Vice President, His Excellency Yılmaz, Vice Premier of China, His Excellency Li Feng, Iranian Foreign Minister, Mr. Abdul Hayyan, Foreign Minister's visit to the United Arab Emirates, and his participation in a special session of Organization of the Islamic Cooperation. Vice Premier of the State Council of China, His Excellency He Lifeng, visited Pakistan as special representative of President Xi Jinping in connection with the 10th anniversary of Pakistan-China Economic Corridor. The visit was an opportunity for the two sides to discuss bilateral relations and explore new horizons of collaboration in trade and investment. The two sides reaffirmed their continued commitment to CPEC and expressed their firm resolve to build upon the achievements of the last decade and to continue cooperation for further developing it as a high-quality, demonstrable project of BRI. CPEC has brought huge dividends to Pakistan, as manifested in creation of over 200,000 jobs, addition of over 800,000 megawatts power to national grid, building of 510 kilometers of highways and 932 kilometers of road network, and an 820 kilometer long optical fiber line. Areas of cooperation under CPEC phase two include rural revitalization, agricultural development, industrialization, green development, and science and technology. The two countries remain committed to enhance cooperation under CPEC and develop it as a connectivity project for the region. During the visit of Vice President of the Republic of Turkey, the two sides jointly inaugurated the fourth Milgram class corvette, PNS Tariq, at Karachi Shipyard. The project to construct four corvettes for the Pakistan Navy was initiated in 2018. The project symbolizes close partnership between Pakistan and Turkey in defense production. During his visit to Islamabad, the Iranian Foreign Minister Hussein Amir Abdul Hayyan held wide-ranging talks with Foreign Minister Bilawal Bhutto Zardari and called on Prime Minister, Chairman, Senate, and Speaker of the National Assembly. The two sides agreed to further strengthen multidimensional cooperation in trade and economy, energy, and culture and arts. There were major convergences on a range of issues, including regional connectivity and Islamophobia. Three key documents of understanding were signed during the visit. These include the five-year trade cooperation plan, which sets a bilateral trade target of $5 billion, prioritizes removing impediments on bilateral trade, finalization of FTA, and establishment of institutional linkages between respective private sectors. The two sides came to an understanding on repatriation of sentenced persons in respective jails, to release all fishermen in custody, to waive off any fines imposed on them, and to release their vessels. A document of economic and trade cooperation was also signed between the Chambers of Commerce of Tehran and Karachi. During his one-day visit to the UAE on 30th of July, Foreign Minister Bilawal Bhutto Zardari conveyed heartfelt condolences to His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Zayed Al Nahyan on the sad demise of His Highness Sheikh Said bin Zayed Al Nahyan. The two foreign ministers discussed bilateral relations between Pakistan and the UAE and exchanged views on regional and global developments in the region. On 31st of July, Foreign Minister Bilawal Bhutto Zardari attended the 18th extraordinary meeting of the OIC Council of Foreign Ministers, convened to debate the recurring incidents of the desecration of the Holy Quran. The foreign minister condemned the Islamophobic and hateful acts of desecration of the Holy Quran and underscored the need for shunning religious hatred and for promoting interfaith harmony and peaceful coexistence. He reiterated the call for appointment of a UN special envoy to combat Islamophobia. We are pleased with the outcome of the extraordinary CFM that adopted a comprehensive resolution endorsing the 8-point action plan unanimously agreed upon by UN Human Rights Council to counter incitement to hatred, discrimination, stigmatization, and violence based on religion and belief. Pakistan's cricket team will participate in the ICC Cricket World Cup to be held in India. Our decision to participate reflects Pakistan's consistent position that sports cannot be mixed with politics. Pakistan's constructive and responsible approach contrasts with that of India, which has repeatedly politicized sports by refusing to send its cricket team to Pakistan for the Asia Cup or denying visas for Pakistan's blind cricket team. During its visit to India, we expect the Pakistan cricket team to receive the requisite courtesies and full safety and security. Our deep concerns about the security of Pakistan's cricket team are being conveyed to the International Cricket Council and the Indian authorities. On the 5th of August, the Pakistani nation expressed complete solidarity with their Kashmiri brothers and sisters on the occasion of the 4th anniversary of India's illegal and unilateral actions of 5th August in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir. Since 2019, India has taken a series of measures to alter the demographic makeup of IIOJK and intensified its suppression of the Kashmiri people. India has carried out a selective delimitation of electoral constituencies, issued fake domiciles to millions of non-Kashmiris, and added hundreds of thousands of temporary residents to alter the existing voter rolls. These measures are aimed at disenfranchising the people of Kashmir and converting them into a disempowered minority in their own land in gross violation of the 4th Geneva Convention. Pakistan believes that the people of Jammu and Kashmir have the right to determine their own future in a UN-supervised plebiscite as enshrined in the relevant UN Security Council resolutions. Pakistan will continue to extend political, diplomatic, and moral support to our Kashmiri brothers and sisters for the just and peaceful settlement of the Jammu and Kashmir dispute in accordance with the UN Security Council resolutions. I thank you.